scrap. And this is the predictable one. It's Matt Martin and Eric Gudbranson.
Jim, it's almost like, okay, you got a two-goal game now. Maybe now this is the right time.
And Gudbranson might have been thinking, I got to do this after the events of November 5th. Branson's a big, tough boy, as you can see. And Martin is as well.
And it started slow, but boy, did it ever go with a flurry.
They
were grappling early, kind of cautiously trying to get position, and then all of a sudden...
Over the last number of years, and it was all Ducks early in the second period, they came out, Kessler scored to tie it 1-1, and you were starting to think, this is the Ducks team you're used to seeing. They were forechecking aggressively, they were getting chances, and
chased on a Kramarosa. Off the faceoff, they were going at each other on the wing.
I'm surprised the officials didn't step in with how much they were whacking each other with the sticks.
So Chiasson takes his helmet off, trying to avoid those left hands. Wow, big right hand by Kramarosa.
Second fight for Kramarosa in two games against the Flames. He fought Matthew Tkachuk back on November 15th. Not November 15th, the last time they met up, the 6th.
Oh!
Kramarosa with the big right hands on Alex Chiasson.
Tell you what, hey, just because I combed my hair with a pork chop.
Oh,
we got another fight here. Yeah, Max Domi.
Max Domi is going after somebody's going after Hathaway, and they are throwing haymakers.
Oh, are they ever? There is no defense in this one.
And Max Domi is absolutely going after him.
And the linesmen get into that one. My goodness.
Max Domi throws him rather quickly, and they're heavy. They're heavy hits.
Oh, he took one right in the left eye.
Yeah, he got caught in the eye there, as you can see.
Well, for Martin Jones, whose credentials are very good coming into this game, you go back to that loss to Ottawa that you mentioned earlier, Brian. He's faced only 25 shots in the last four games. He's now given up 5 goals, and Wingles is going at it with Kramarosa. They were a good 50 feet away from the play, but the two of them right off the faceoff got entangled and took it all the way to the boards. Kramarosa.
He's saying no to the linesman. He doesn't want him to come in.
He says, let this continue because I got a free right hand. And Tommy Wingles wishes the linesman had come in.
Car crash in the corner. Hamhuis trying to get it forward. They're going to go. Shen and Stephen Johns. Oh, uppercut by Johns. Now some rabbit lefts by Shen. Stephen Johns, the Pennsylvania boy. Now, oh, another uppercut by Johns. Shen busy with the right. Both of their visors are foggy. Another right by Johns. Uppercut. Johns trying to rip the helmet off of Braden Shen. And as they go to the glass, the whistles blow, the linesmen come in.
Graevat ahead to Gabriel. Into the Florida zone. Gabriel drives to the net. He's pulled down and no penalty coming. Now there will be as the gloves are on the ice. And Gabriel once again going at it, this time with McElrath.
Well, he got knocked down, poked the puck, almost scored on it, and ran into Luongo. He really had no choice, but and then drops the gloves immediately to get this team fired up once again. And keep in mind, he's got a cut right finger, so he can't really throw too much with that right hand. That's why you might see him switch to the left like he did against Reeves versus St. Louis. It's not natural for him, but he's doing a heck of a job nevertheless.
Well, these are a couple of tired fighters.
Oh boy, they can't even lift their arms anymore, but they're still throwing bombs.
And finally, the linesmen step in. That's 6 fights in 9 NHL games for Gabriel.
Well, he's got to create some offensive chances. Jacob Joseph knows that, but they need him to contribute and be an offensive threat. Now we got a scrap right off the draw. And these are two guys we would expect, Chris Neal and Luke Gadzik. Oh, boy. And there's some big punches thrown by Gadzik as Neal caught him early.
These are heavyweights.
Oh, my. This is a little old school. Stand back and let them fly.
Forbert with that front off the side of the net, chased down by we get a fight. Oh, here's a renewal of an old rivalry between McLeod and Thorburn. A couple of quick rights by McLeod. Left, and a big hook by McLeod lands with that left hand. Another right by McLeod. Thorburn trying to come back. McLeod holding on to his right hand and getting his right hand free. Now they tie up in the corner. Push off the boards, and the fight continues. They're letting this one go a while. A couple of more right jabs by McLeod. A big roundhouse right missed by McLeod. And they look start to be a little arm-weary, and finally, the linesman have separated.
Now this is Severson for the Devils to the left side, and Miles Wood with a shot to the glove of Fleury.
Well, the Devils are getting some opportunities. Now Wood, a couple of shots. We got a scrap going.
Alexi right in the middle of it again.
Boy, Wood's big. Alessi is a gamer.
This is a toe-to-toe battle right here.
Man.
Wood still has a glove on his left hand. He didn't get the glove off.
Schrader back to play it for Minnesota. Here we go. They'll drop the gloves. It's Stewart and Anderson.
Oh, we figured something was going to happen because Stewart was trying to get under the bonnet of just about anybody, and he made a big hit on the defenseman, and then Anderson steps in, and boy, are they throwing some haymakers. Couple of pretty good sized fellas here too, throwing bombs.
The season. Oh, we got a scrap here.
Yeah, and it's going to be Ryan White.
These guys fought last time these two clubs met, and I know Haley wants a rematch.
Yeah, White and Haley, and here they go. Ryan White coming back with a bunch of rights. And he pops the helmet off as well.
White got the better of him in this last exchange. Oh, he's giving him the how do you do's and knocks him down and an upper. He's got the lawnmower going now. Fighting in hockey is a lot about rhythm. As Haley bounces back in this fight, switches hands now as well. A couple kidney shots.
And they continue to go. That last one caught Ryan White. What a scrap.
Yeah, that caught him right on the chin.